Hello and welcome back to another episode of FFBE. So today I'm gonna do a unit showcase for Ibarra. Before we go into the fight, I want to talk about her something here. The first thing first is she is a true double hand mage that does lightning damage in her normal form, and two dual wheel mage that does dark damage in her brave form. In her normal form, her magna ability Inazuma has a 300% buff for her magic and magic damage for human and fairy for 100% for fighter. So this magna is very good. Yes, very good. Many people might think that she has another magna ability on her brave form, and that magna also have a 150% human and fairy killer. Why don't you use that? So the reason that we're not gonna use that is we focus on lightning damage because of her cooldown to shift from normal to brave or brave to normal is very very long. If you want to use lightning damage and shift to use a magnet ability on her brave form, you're gonna wait 5 turns before come back to her normal form. So we have this magna ability on her normal form. It's very very good thing. The second one is her cooldown. This gonna be a main problem for her in the future too. Her cooldown able to decrease lightning resistance for 120% for 4 turns. Increase her magic 300% for 5 turns. Increase human fairy killer for 4 turns. And enable quad cast for 5 turns. This is the only slot for 120% Imperial. If you find a boss that needs to dispel like Behemoth, you have to go back to her main chaining skill, which has on demand 80% Imperial. Yes, you heard it correctly, 80% Imperial. She don't have any 100% in her kit. But if you can kill boss in 1 or 2 turns, this might not be a problem for that. Her main shining skill is Arashi. It's a Chaos Wave Awakened Shining family that had 7 plus 1 hit. It deal a massive amount of damage, but it is an AoE shining skill with Dark Vision player don't like this. Because AoE shining skill have a bug, so it stops casting when a monster die. We don't want that because we want overkill damage to maximize our score. But still, she still has some single target shiny move. It's not as much powerful as her Arashi. Kaminari is her lightning magic single target shiny move that does 30 multiplier ignore speed for 50%. Alright, the rest gonna be her 2 cooldown skill that does a high damage. Another cooldown skill that have 80% spirit spare. This may be a pretty cool thing for her using her as a spirit breaker, so you don't need to bring breaker alongside her. For her bear form, as I said before, that her magnet has pretty much the same thing but have higher killer for 150% human and fairy killer with a dark elemental magic damage. So this is better, but you cannot shift back for 5 turns. So if you focus on lightning elemental damage, you still need to use her magnet in her normal form. On her brave form, her cooldown is not her damage anymore. Her cooldown, the first one is Supernatural Frenzy. So this one gonna be her modifier boost for Angoku, which is her main chaining move. So you pretty much need to use the cooldown first, and then you're gonna use Angoku. Another thing that different in her brave form is she has 6 multiplying chaining cap here because she is a 2 dual wheel mage. This is a real 2 dual wheel mage, and you should build her 2 dual wheel here because 6 chaining cap. She had very high damage on her limit in her brave form. Many people said that she can be a Tifa in a mage form. Her limit is decrease dark resistance for 100% for 3 turns. Increase her magic for 200% 250% for 5 turns. and deal 180% modifier on dark magic damage. Oh, the thing that I forgot about her is she has full limit bird gauge at the start of the battle with this skill, teeming energy. That's pretty much all about her. The way to use her that she can be your chainer or limit finisher. So her limit finisher is locked to dark element in her breath form. And for a chaining skill, you can use her on a dark element or lightning element. Let's start with the fast clear. So this clear, we're gonna use Ibarra as limit bird finisher and chainer. Paladin Caesar is going to be our magic cover tank. He needs 200% in earth and fire resistance. Don't forget that every unit needs status immunity. Rosa is going to be our gauge breaker. So Antonella weak to rot, so we equip her with 2 rot. Erlen gonna be our main breaker. She needs status protection in this form. Because we don't use her that much in this form, you can gear anything you want. But in her bear form, we need as high attack as possible. Because we're gonna use her as support chainer. Iba gonna be our limit bird finisher. We use Starlight Elena guard to get an extra 50% limit bird damage. And in normal form, you can gear pretty much anything with status immunity because we're gonna focus in her breath form. So you need as high magic as possible along with plant killer. Yoshiki is gonna be our buffer and limit bird damage buffer. So he equipped with 2 rod because we're gonna use him to help Rosa to do a gauge breaking. Our friend still needs status immunity too. That pretty much we need for this fight. Alright, let's go. We start with Paladin Caesar, so he's gonna changing stand and do a magic cover. Rosa gonna do a gauge breaking with 2 radiant arrows. Orlin gonna do 85% status breaking. Iba gonna shift into her breath form and using her cooldown with Corrupted Thought and Echo Cook. Yoshiki is gonna dual cast hit 2 cooldown. And we start the chain. On the second turn, we start with Rosa to finish her baking with a 2 radiant arrow. Paladin Caesar is gonna do his limit burst. This is a setup in case of we unable to kill boss in 4 turns. Lauren gonna do her Grandis and Kuda for capping the chain. Yoshiki is gonna shift and imbuing Lauren with ice buffing stat and do some physical buff. Ibarra gonna quad double cat and Coco. Send Ibarra first and then followed by Lauren. right? Or the root is death. This turn, so we're gonna use Iba Limiter to do a burst damage. Starting with Rosa, so I cast React here to Paladin's still gonna use his triple cast on Dark Stardust Ray Shining. Lauren also do a triple cast on her Stardust Ray Shining. Yoshi here got a dual cast here and using his Magnet for Limit Bird damage buff and Champion Vitality for Magic Mitigation. Iba gonna cast her Limit Bird. Alright, send Stardust Ray first, waiting 2 seconds and then send Limit Bird. Even if we cannot kill boss in this turn, but still, that pretty decent damage. Okay, on this turn, Rosa gonna do her stop with Gage Breaking with Radiant Arrow. Paralysis is gonna do Changing Stand, Cover, and Lunalian Mind for Magic Mitigation. Yoshihiri gonna triple cast anything to deal damage on the boss for helping Rosa play the game. Lauren gonna use her Grandis and cooldown and her single hit move for capping the chain. Ibra gonna quadruple cast and Koku to chain. Alright, start chaining with Ibra and send Lauren after that. Wow, even we have a break gauge, he still does some damage and finish the boss. Let's start with her good thing first. The first one is she did pretty decent damage on both Shenron and Limit Bird finisher form. So on a chart, Tifa is the only one that able to surpass her damage. So her damage is pretty good. Not only her damage, she also have many AoE skill. If you have to fight a boss with A, B, C, D, E, she is pretty much good choice for that. The second one is she is a mage, and if you focus on the dark vision and want to have high score on it, you need to pull for every mage in this game. So that's the reason to pull for her no matter what. The third one is her vision guard is one of the best vision guard for mage in this game. Another guard that very good for mage is from the Soul Neo Vision, but he get delay and we never know that we gonna get Soul or not. If we not get Soul, this guard gonna be the best one in global. Move on to the bad thing. I said about Dark Vision earlier, right? So she still have some bad thing for Dark Vision fight too. As we know so far, that AoE skill is blocked in this game. It stop when monster die, but we don't want that because we want overkill damage to get high score in Dark Vision. You need to do some trick on her that for her quadruple cast. First two cast you're gonna do AoE skill. On cast number 3 and number 4, you're gonna do a single target skill to complete her quadruple cast and make it not stop in between. The second one is her breath form duration is only for 5 turns. And the third one is her shift cooldown is extremely long. For real, she is this pretty bad on the mage because it's different from Starlight Elena case. Elena also have 4 turn duration on her breath form. But you can use her normal form because her breath form is does higher damage. But Ibarra is different because her breath form is dark elemental damage and normal form is lightning damage. which means that you can use dark damage only for 5 turns. If you can kill the boss in 5 turns, you have to wait another 5 turns before you're able to shift back to her breath form. And the fourth one is she needs so many external support. Many people said that she's gonna be another mage like Tifa, but she not completely like Tifa because first she don't have any innately limited damage in her passive. Second, she don't have any skill that do a limited damage buff. So in many clear that able to clear boss in turn 1, you need Yoshikiri or Rainio Vision to do a limited damage buff for her. And the final one is she has mediocre impel. She has 120%, but that only available on her cooldown, which means that if you have to dispel bot or bot able to dispel itself, like a behemoth fight that you have to dispel behemoth every single turn, she might not be good for that if you are unable to kill behemoth in 1 or 2 turns. And on-demand impel on her is only 80%. This is the thing that I don't understand. We are in the Neo Vision era and we still see 50% and 80% elemental imperial in Neo Vision unit. That really gumi? Alright, for conclusion, should you pull for her? I'm gonna say yes if you focus on Dark Vision and want to have a high score for Mage State. Other than that, no. She is good, but she has so many downsides on her. She needs external support. Her impel is not that good. If you have a physical damage dealer, I suggest you to use that physical damage dealer and waiting for next 1 or 2 banner, because Kingdom Hearts is on the horizon. Vizalet gonna release in 1 or 2 months. And she is Kuja 2.0, which is better than Ibarra in my opinion. Alright, that's pretty much for today. Thanks for watching and bye.